Dear friends, welcome to this edition of VBS Anatoma. Here is a series of digital lectures in the Gross Anatomy series. This series is called VBS Anatoma. The topic that we have taken now is the larynx, of which it is part 2, the previous video we have just released yesterday, that is the thyroid cartilage. In this larynx 2, we will discuss the cricoid and arytenoid cartilages. I also call these as lockdown lectures or study at home lectures because of the currently running corona pandemic. Since the classes are suspended, at least I believe that these will form a theoretical backdrop before you come over at a later date for the practicals. I am Dr. Balasubramaniam. I am a professor in the Department of Anatomy at St. John's Medical College, Bangalore, India. Let's have a quick walk through the image-based MCQs. MCQ number one. Here is a model of the larynx anterolateral view. There is a particular structure that has been pointed out with the flashing arrow. Identify it. There are four options. One of them is the correct answer. Identify the item. Next, to give you an orientation, this is a superior view or view from the top of the larynx. The ivory colored structure is very clearly the hyoid bone, but then let's take a look at the other items. One particular structure has been highlighted by the flashing arrow. Think over and identify that structure. Next, let's look at an actual dissected specimen of the laryngeal area. The hint I can give you is here is a posterior view. One particular structure has been highlighted and there are four options available here. Identify that particular structure. Four MCQ. MCQ number four. Yet another structure has been shown by a flashing arrow. Lateral anterolateral view of the larynx model. Last MCQ, posterior view of the larynx. One particular structure has been flashed up or pointed out with a flashing arrow. It's a small element of that structure. Identify that item. All the answers are given at the end of the video after the discussion. Now let's start the discussion. The cricoid cartilage can be compared to a signet ring. It has a arch and a plate at the posterior aspect, which we call the lamina. Here is a diagram. Here is a slide where the model of the larynx, the cartilage model with a few ligaments is shown. One side is the anterior view and the other side is the posterior view. Here, let's identify the cricoid cartilage. See that in the anterior view, the cricoid ring is very well seen located below the thyroid cartilage. In the posterior view, the cricoid lamina is well seen. You can see on the top of it is the arytenoid cartilage, pyramid-shaped, two pyramid-shaped structures adjacent to each other along the upper border of the cricoid lamina. Now, slowly we are beginning to see not only the cricoid but also adjacent structures. In both the views, the cricothyroid joint is also clearly seen. Now, the cricoid ring, the view is anterior view of the model of the larynx. You can see the cricoid ring very clearly, as I shown you in the previous slide, but certain parts of the cricoid ring need to be noticed: an anterior surface and a posterior surface, upper border and the lower border. The lower border is in continuity with the commencement of the trachea. There is a ligament, cricotracheal ligament, binding it to the trachea. The upper border has the attachment of the two membranes, the cricothyroid membrane. The central midline part of which is also thickened to form the corresponding ligament, cricothyroid ligament. But then, in addition to it, it also gives attachment for the conus elasticus. The conus, it is deep to the cricothyroid membrane. At a later stage, we will see some muscle is also attached there, but we will keep that for pending for now. Again, the same model, you can see the joint between the cricoid and the thyroid cartilage. As I mentioned in the previous discussion, the cricotracheal ligament has been highlighted. Further below it are the tracheal rings. Next, here is a model of the larynx where, in addition to cartilages, the membranes, the ligaments, the muscles and other immediate attached structures are also shown. For example, the cricothyroid membrane and ligament, that white area is very clearly visible just above the upper border of the cricoid. On this side, you can see the muscle running like a wing from the cricoid to the lower margin of the thyroid cartilage. Now, that's the cricothyroid muscle. In addition, there is one more part related, one more structure related, that's the lobe of the thyroid gland, which is plastered to the side of the cricoid cartilage. Next, here is an anterolateral view of the larynx. The thyroid lamina of the right side has been removed and the cut edge of the thyroid lamina has been shown on the as a label. I called it as sagittal section thyroid lamina. Having removed the thyroid lamina, you can see a lot of muscles deep interior. I have already introduced you to the cricothyroid muscle. At that stage, in the previous slides, I told you there is one more muscle along the upper border of the cricoid. Now, that muscle is the lateral cricoarytenoid muscle. It runs posteriorly towards the arytenoid cartilage. Next. Now we are in the posterior view. We have finished with the cricoid ring. Let's look at the cricoid lamina. As I told you, it is the wider part of the signet ring shaped cricoid structure. Incidentally, the cricoid is the only cartilage which completely encircles the larynx and forms a wall of the larynx. This lamina is more or less quadrangular. It has an upper border, to which at the supralateral edges, the arytenoids are attached, or there is a joint, a synovial joint. That's why I have also pointed out the two pyramidal shaped, that is paired cartilage, the arytenoid cartilage. Next, the lower border, as already told, continues with the trachea. The cricotracheal ring can be seen here also, or the cricotracheal the ligament can be seen here also. The posterior and the anterior surfaces of this lamina are noteworthy. The anterior surface is fully clothed with mucous membrane of this larynx, but the posterior surface presents a median ridge and two shallow areas on either sides. As you will see, the two shallow areas give origin to the posterior cricoarytenoid muscle, one of the most important muscles of the body, because it causes abduction of the vocal cord that we will see in the next discussion. Now, the same lamina, you can see the cricoarytenoid joint, the articulation. You can also see towards the edges the posterior border of the thyroid cartilage. The thin, light yellow vocal cord has also been kept in position. That can also be noted. It extends from the arytenoid cartilage to the thyroid angle at a point right below the lower tip of the epiglottis. Next, here is a little more. Having gone through the skeletal parts, we will move into a little more higher version of the larynx with more structures shown, like all the muscles, the nerves, and all the vessels have been added to this. So it appears a little complicated. Nevertheless, let's identify one by one. The blue area, this is a posterior view of the larynx. The cricoid lamina is very, very well seen. That's the posterior view. As I told you in the previous discussion, the muscle attached there is the posterior cricoarytenoid muscle. It runs upwards laterally to be attached to the muscular process of the arytenoid cartilage. Now, small bits of arytenoid cartilage is also seen as blue spots, particularly the apex of the cartilage is seen. Interrupting the view of the arytenoid cartilage in this model are the oblique arytenoid muscles. I repeat, oblique arytenoid muscles. And right above the cricoid lamina, you can see a small part of the transverse arytenoid muscle. This muscle is deep to the oblique arytenoid. That's why the posterior view, first the oblique arytenoid comes into view, then the transverse arytenoid. You can also see, incidentally, the recurrent laryngeal nerve coursing upwards from below upwards. Next, let's examine the arytenoid cartilage. I have called them as the twin dancing cartilages, pyramidal cartilages. This is a three-sided pyramid. The two medial surfaces, that means the medial surface of adjacent arytenoids, face each other along the midline. They can move apart laterally to some extent. Then there is a lateral surface, and seen in this posterior view of this pyramid, on the upper end is the apex, and lower lateral end is the muscular process. I repeat, muscular process. You can see there are two arytenoids seated on the top or the summit of the cricoid lamina. I repeat, also seen the lateral surface, medial surface, apex above, and muscular process laterally. Next, this is a top view, that means superior view of the larynx. The ivory colored structure is the hyoid bone. The epiglottis leaf like structure is highlighted by a label. The vocal cord is seen running from the arytenoid cartilage to the angle of the thyroid. Now, at the posterior end of the vocal cord, you can see the anterior process or the vocal process of the arytenoid cartilage. Therefore, this is a very important. In this view, the anterior process or the vocal process of the arytenoid cartilage is very clearly seen. Next, here is another model of the larynx, where in addition to the cartilage, principal cartilages, the muscles, vessels, the mucous membrane has been applied on the surface, therefore giving a more realistic picture of the larynx. Now, there is a fold of mucosa running from the epiglottis to the arytenoid cartilage. That is called the aryepiglottic fold, shown here by an L-shaped arrow. I repeat, it runs from the epiglottis to the arytenoid cartilage. That fold is a mucosal fold. That is the aryepiglottic fold. Now, along the fold, there are two swellings. One swelling is very, very posterior, almost at the tip of the arytenoid cartilage, upper tip of the arytenoid cartilage. That is the corniculate cartilage. A little anteriorly and laterally along the aryepiglottic fold is the other cartilage, cuneiform cartilage. I repeat, cuneiform cartilage. Just to complete, the ivory colored structure of the uppermost rim is the hyoid bone. I repeat, that's the hyoid bone. Now you see, because of the mucus flap or the mucus fold running from the epiglottis to the arytenoid cartilage, the so-called aryepiglottic fold, immediately lateral to it, the oral mucosa, the laryngopharyngeal mucosa, takes a shallow coverage and moves towards the lateral wall of the pharynx to create the piriform fossa. Similarly, anteriorly, between the epiglottis and the anterior edge of the hyoid bone, and in terms of soft tissue, the tongue, there is another fossa called the valicula. So in this slide, watch carefully the aryepiglottic fold. Immediately lateral to it is the piriform fossa. Also in front, separating the anterior edge of the aryepiglottic fold from the tongue is the valicula. Now, having seen the models, it's time we graduate to the next level, going through the specimens, the actual dissected specimens. Here is an anterolateral view of the larynx. The huge pearl blue thyroid lamina is seen. Lower down, the cricoid ring is seen, and attached to it in a brown color is the muscle cricothyroid. It runs from the cricoid ring to the lower border of the thyroid lamina. This muscle is the cricothyroid muscle. Next, this is yet another dissected specimen. This is a posterior view where you can see, I have shown this in a previous video, you can see the epiglottis at the uppermost end. As you go lower down, you can see the lamina of the cricoid cartilage, and it is flanked on either sides by the posterior cricoarytenoid muscle. I told you there is a shallow area on either sides of the posterior median ridge on the posterior surface of the lamina. Now that is very clearly seen in this slide. There is a midline posterior median ridge. Because of the ridge, there are two shallow areas on either sides. Those shallow areas, the origin of posterior cricoarytenoid muscle. The rest of the cricoid lamina is projecting upwards above the posterior cricoarytenoid, to which the arytenoid cartilage is attached. And because of the muscle behind it, the oblique arytenoid, the arytenoid itself, the cartilage itself, is not clearly visible in this particular specimen. Yet another dissection, fresh dissection, posterior view of the larynx. You can see very clearly the tongue, the epiglottis, the airy epiglottic fold running towards, running from the upper edge of the epiglottis to the arytenoid cartilage. And below that, you can see below the arytenoid cartilage, the cricoid lamina. This is a very, very important photograph. You have to get an orientation. I repeat, tongue, upper edge of the epiglottis, airy epiglottic fold, then the arytenoid cartilage, and below it, the cricoid lamina. These are the structures you have to appreciate. In the same specimen, also appreciate immediately behind the tongue, the valicula, and immediately lateral to the hairy epiglottic fold, the piriform fossa. I repeat, watch carefully. This is a fresh specimen. Immediately lateral to the hairy epiglottic fold is the piriform fossa, and in front of it is the valicula. That means valicula is right behind the tongue. I have also retained the label of the arytenoid cartilage. Next, here is another fresh specimen. This is an anterior view. I repeat, anterolateral view. This is not the same as previous specimen. This is an anterior view. Here you can see that the cartilages have been sectioned to take a look into the interior. You can see the thyroid cartilage, a huge lamina. You can see the cut cricoid arch cut in the midline anteriorly. And between the lower border of the thyroid cartilage, watch carefully, and the upper margin of the cricoid arch, you can see that nice glistening cricothyroid membrane, the central thickening of which is the corresponding ligament, cricothyroid ligament. You can also see attaching the cricoid to the tracheal rings is the cricotracheal ligament right below the cricoid arch. Next, the dissected specimen, the fresh dissected specimen, I have opened it out. It's basically the previous specimen, that previous slide which I showed you. We have opened it out. You can note carefully, the uppermost part of it is the tongue. You can see the arytenoid cartilage along the posterior part. You can see along the anterior wall, the epiglottis, the uppermost tip of the epiglottis. And watch particularly in this case, there are two mucosal folds, a lower fold and an upper fold. I have deliberately labeled only the lower fold. That fold is the vocal fold. It runs between the arytenoid cartilage to the angle of the thyroid in front, thyroid cartilage in front. The other unlabeled fold is the vestibular fold. We will come to it in the detailed discussion of the interior of the larynx. But for the moment, in this specimen, note tongue, epiglottis, arytenoid cartilage, and the vocal cord. Now, with this orientation and a little more detailed reorientation in an actual dissected specimen, let's re-look at the MCQs once again. Remember, this round we are going to give you the answers. MCQ number one, that is the cricothyroid muscle. I repeat, cricothyroid muscle. See, it is running between the cricoid arch and the lower border of the thyroid cartilage. It goes right backwards up to the inferior horn. Next, MCQ number two, that is the vocal cord. That's the vocal cord. It is the upper edge of the conus elasticus or the cricovocal membrane. Now, there is a fresh specimen. The flashing structure here is the hairy epiglottic fold. We are giving you the details in the discussion. Now, this one is the cricoid lamina. Remember, although it's a lateral anterolateral view, the arrow is pointing to the posteriormost part of the cricoid. Therefore, it has to be the cricoid lamina. Next, the last MCQ, The structure as a whole is the arytenoid cartilage. The part of that particular structure pointed by the arrow is the apex, upper edge of the arytenoid cartilage. That was an overview of two other cartilages of the larynx, namely the cricoid and the arytenoid cartilages. Students, I'm sure you will have some doubts or some feedback. You can write to me at this email ID, or you can post your queries or feedback in the blog area below the YouTube video. Thank you for your patient listening and viewing this video. I hope you have benefited from this. Basically, these are all pre-dissection videos, ideally to be seen just before you start dissecting. You can see it multiple times during the dissection, and most importantly, once the dissection is over, till you reach go to the exam, you can go on repeatedly play the videos so that you can keep yourself updated, and that'll add to your memory. Thank you. All the best.